Hello everyone, welcome to another video in the Aerospace Student Tutorials and Video Series. Joining me today, I've got our new Aerospace Student Programs Technical Lead, Khushin who works in our Bangalore office. Hello Khushin, welcome to your first video for the Aerospace Series.
Thanks a lot, Connell.
So Khushin, why don't you go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself and why you'd be the best person to talk about aerospace with student content for us.
Thanks, Connell. As you introduced, I'm working with the student programs team and I support the aerospace competitions globally. So I have been interacting with the student competition teams worldwide, and I found out that how they have been doing. And even when I was the student, I was also involved in such competitions, and also the aircraft design and flight controls are two of my major area of interest. So I have been trying my hands on the multiple tools, and finally I come up with something which the teams require.
Awesome. So today's Khushin is going to help us understand what sensitivity analysis is for aero modeling competition. Now, sensitivity analysis at a high level is essentially trying to it's one of the first design steps that you take as a team that's building model airplanes. So without wasting too much time, let's jump right into our topic for today. Khushin, the floor is all yours.
Thanks, Connell. So today we are going to discuss about the sensitivity analysis, and our discussion would be especially around the aero modeling competition. So first we'll be starting our discussion with the understanding what is sensitivity analysis. Once we understand the sensitivity analysis, we will be exploring why is it important for aero modeling competitions, and we will be also taking a case study which is based on the AIAA Design Build Fly 2021 competition score problem, and we will be solving this problem using the MATLAB. So we'll be having a software demonstration, and after that we will be concluding with some of the key takeaways, and we'll explore that how sensitivity analysis can help us to take a better design decisions so that we can maximize our score for the competition.
Awesome. So without wasting too much time, let's learn what sensitivity analysis is.
So sensitivity analysis is basically a study to measure the impact of uncertainties in input on output variables of a model. It also helps to determine most sensitive input variable and the range of input variable input values where model will be most sensitive. By getting this understanding, we can actually design our aircraft or design our system in such a way which gives us the best possible score. The sensitivity analysis is done with the multiple methods, but mostly it's performed with the univariate, multivariate, and local and global methods. Today we are going to keep our discussion around the univariate sensitivity analysis, and we'll be exploring design space with this. So let's move forward and understand why the sensitivity analysis is important for aero modeling competitions. Mostly in the aero modeling competition, we see that organizers gives us the conflict-free design requirements, and as the team wants to maximize their score, so lots of confusion are there that, okay, which design space should be chosen. So sensitivity analysis actually helps us to identify the most sensitive design variable for a given scoring formula. It also helps us to make the better design decisions among the conflicting mission requirements. And finally, it helps us to optimize the aircraft design for a better score.
So I can see how this is important for, you know, a complex system like an aircraft where everything's coupled together, right? You know, you increase the size of your wing, you got to increase, you know, there are going to be corresponding changes in fuselage length, for example, just to make sure that your aircraft is stable. So, I can see how having to, you know, programmatically or mathematically essentially check how much a change in one particular design variables affects something in the other. So I can see how this can help you get started.
Yes. We are going to discuss the same with this case study. So we are having this case study of AIAA Design Build Fly competition of 2021. So in this competition, teams need to fly for this course layout, and they had the mission, multiple missions. So in mission one, it was binary where they need to make a successful flight. So if they are making a successful flight, it would be one, else they would be scoring zero. In mission two, they had the two design variables, and those design variables, those score formula was actually the comparative to the best team. Similarly, for the mission three, also they need to score relative score to the best team, and there were total three design variables. So number of laps, sensor length, flight time. So in this competition, actually the teams need to tow a number of sensors, as a payload, for the complete mission. And finally, they had the ground mission. So ground mission was again depends on the crew skills, and it was just to load and unload the payload in the mission. So total mission score was the sum of all.
So just off the looks of it, it kind of seems like a very, you know, it seems like very conflicting scores, because on one hand you're measured for flight time, so you always want a lighter or a smaller aircraft if you want to fly faster.
Yeah.
But then you're also getting points for actually carrying more payloads and carrying more sensors, so that automatically means a heavier aircraft, right? So it's I can see these are very, very sort of antithetical missions, if you will.
Yes, Connell, you took it right. Actually, the problem the teams face is to choose between a faster aircraft or a heavier aircraft, and we will be exploring through our demonstration that, okay, should we choose a faster or heavier aircraft? So just let's quickly move to our software demonstration and we'll explore it from there. To perform the sensitivity analysis, we have developed a MATLAB live script. In this script, we will be exploring about the multiple mission scores and identify which design variables are most sensitive. So we start our work with the mathematically formulating the mission scores. As we see this in the mission scores, relative scores are there for mission two and mission three. So we need to take a best score or best team score. So depending on the previous year reports, we have come up with the performance of a best team, and we modeled all the parameters of the best team, and then we are identifying that, okay, our team is the best team. So just to start, we are assigning our team variables to the best team variables. Moving forward, all the mathematical formulas for the scores has been modified. Once we are ready with this, we have actually introduced the change variable. This change variable will help us to introduce the change in the various design variables. We are starting from minus 50 and will be minus 50%, and we will be going to up to the plus 50%. We'll be seeing that how the change of each design variables making impact on the total mission score. So we have performed this sensitivity analysis first on three missions, on the mission two score, mission three score, and ground mission score. So here we see this beautiful plot which shows that, okay, all three curves has the positive slopes. So positive slopes means the direct or proportional relation with the variable. So if my input variable is changed or design variable is changed, it will be directly impacting the mission score. So, mission three is the most sensitive mission, followed by mission two, and the ground mission is the one which is the least sensitive mission. And as the ground mission involves the loading and unloading of the payload, and it depends highly on the crew skills. So we can neglect this for our further analysis. But mission two and mission three score has the multiple design variables. So mission two has two design variables. Those are sensor flight time, and mission three has three design variables, which are number of laps, sensor length, and sensor weight. So now the question is, which one is the most sensitive design variables?
So if we can go back to that plot real quick, essentially what that plot is saying is, depending on how steep the slope is, that's the particular score that is most sensitive to our problem, right? Is that a fair assessment? Okay, cool.
Let's quickly explore the mission two score. So to perform the sensitivity analysis on mission two score, we are defining an array, which is the flight time array. So we are varying here the flight time from the best team's flight time to the a higher limit, which we have considered as a 200 seconds. So in this flight time, we are varying and we'll be plotting the impact of the flight time and the number of sensors here. So we also define a number, another array, which is for the sensor. And then we plot both of the effect of both the variables on the total mission score. Here we see that mission two score has the curves with the negative slope, which means the mission two score has indirect relation or reciprocal relation with the total time, which is actually expected, that lesser the flight time is there, the higher would be the mission score. But another point to identify here is that once we increase the number of sensors, the slopes of the curves started increasing, which actually gives us an understanding that compared to the flight time, the number of sensors or the payload is the, so payload is the more sensitive variable and which is making a more impact on the mission two score. So here we can make some inferences that, okay, as the number of sensors are more sensitive to mission two score than flight time, so heavier aircraft would be a better choice compared to going for a faster aircraft. But if our heavier aircraft gets, if somehow we can make our heavier aircraft fast enough, then we'll be scoring more. So with this understanding of mission two score, we'll be moving now to mission three score. In the mission three, we do have three design variables, which are sensor weight, sensor length, and the number of laps. So we'll be comparing those three variables against each other, and we'll be seeing their impact on the mission three score. So let's start with the discussion on number of laps and sensor weight. So we again define here an array which is going from a zero sensor weight to the highest sensor weight, which was carried by the best team. And then we are introducing the number of laps array as well, and performing and then calculating the mission three score, and we plot it here. We again see that we do have a positive slopes of the curve for the mission three, so that means sensor weight is directly proportional to the mission three score, which is expected, that okay, more the payload you carry, the higher the score you will higher the score would be. Also we identify here that as we are increasing the number of laps, that means the lesser flight time, the score is increasing sharply. So in that case, we can actually inference from here that the heavier aircraft is desired, but if your heavier aircraft again gets faster, you will score more. And that's what we explored in the last mission as well. So we are here with the same understanding. So now let's move to the another correlation study, which is on the number of laps and sensor length. So here again we are introducing a variable, sensor length array. Here we have taken the minimum sensor length, which was given by the competition organizers as a requirement, and we are taking to the highest sensor length, which was carried which can be carried by a best team, introducing them, and again recalculating the mission three score analysis with this, and varying the number of laps, we come up with this plot, which shows that okay, sensor length is also directly proportional to the mission three score, and more the number of laps, the higher the score, which is expected, that okay, the length, the longer your sensor is, it may be more heavy, and it's more heavy, you will be scoring more. So here this mission tells the study tells that if you have a longer sensor, means a longer fuselage, a heavier aircraft, that may result in a better score. So heavier aircraft is again in demand. Moving forward to the last correlation study, which is between the sensor length and sensor weight. So here we have actually kept our number of laps as a constant, and then we have introduced the array between sensor length and sensor weight. So we are using here the mesh grid. So instead of just plotting the curves, we are coming up with a surface here, and Once we do it, we see this beautiful plot, beautiful 3D plot here, which is giving an understanding that, okay, if I do have a smaller sensor and a lighter sensor, I would be scoring less. But if I'm increasing both of them, my mission 3 score will be going up. So here also we get an understanding that, okay, one should carry a heavier and longer sensor, but there are multiple parameters we discussed here, and we need to find which one is the most sensitive design variable. So now we will quickly move to the slides, and we'll bring all our conclusion there, and from there we will try to take a final design decision. So just to recap our total sensitivity analysis study, we started our study with studying the various missions. So we found that mission 3 was most sensitive, followed by mission 2, and then the ground mission was there. In the design variables also, we have two variables in mission 2 and three design variables in mission 3. So the question is, which one is the most sensitive design variables? So let's quickly compare all the results and see which one is the most sensitive design variable. So in mission 2, we saw that slopes are negative, hence flight time impacts inversely. So a lighter and faster aircraft would be less sensitive compared to a heavier aircraft. And a heavier aircraft will be scoring more on getting faster, which we saw in the plots. So here in this mission 2, we found out that, okay, the sensors, number of sensors is the some more sensitive parameter compared to the flight time. So number of sensor is will actually lead to the heavier aircraft or the heavier payload. In the mission 3 score analysis, where we had three studies, so in the three studies we saw that in the first one the sensor weight would be the more sensitive compared to the labs. In the second study we saw that sensor length would be the more sensitive, and in the third one we saw that sensor weight would be the most sensitive parameters. So when we compare all three studies, we find that, okay, sensor weight is the most sensitive, followed by sensor length, and finally the flight time. Now comparing the mission 2 and mission 3 together, if we see the mission 3 was most sensitive, mission 2 was lesser sensitive, but if you look in the all three parameters, sensor weight has been the most sensitive design, variable. So we can take the design decisions from here that a heavier aircraft will be required compared to a lighter and faster aircraft. A longer sensor payload will be scoring higher compared to the smaller sensor. And that's where we go to the key takeaways. So sensitivity, we saw in our discussion that sensitivity analysis helps to identify design variables with the most impact on the mission score. And we also explored that how the MATLAB capabilities helps us to visualize the design space and explore impact of various design variables.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Khushin. I think it opened my eyes a lot more to how, you know, when you go think of it, all of those design variables were, or what we call design variables, were essentially variables made up by the competition. And it's very interesting to see that how this is the first step of your design, right? This is before you start any calculations, you want to say, okay, what am I designing my airplane around? Am I designing it to be lighter? Am I designing it to be faster? Or am I designing it to be heavier and carry a lot more payload? I think this makes a lot of sense as to why. I remember going to the competition in 2021, and the planes were huge. Yeah. Like they were, you know, they could carry a lot of weight. So I think that makes a lot of sense. So hopefully to our audience out there, this helps you all get started with designing aircraft in MATLAB. But Khushin, thank you so much for taking the time to come and talk to us. I'm going to leave you guys with some resources that you can use to get started with using MATLAB and Simulink. Remember, we offer complimentary licenses to everyone taking part in the AIAA Design Build Fly, as well as SAE Aero Design. So if you're taking part in one of those competitions and need to get access to MATLAB, you can use the link on the screen to reach out to us, and we'll help get you set up. But there are also a number of resources, some more videos and blogs that you can take a look at. But please let us know what you'd like to hear more from us about, and we'd be happy to make some more content for you. Thank you so much, and we hope to see you again on this video series.